Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Salute. Pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated.
Please don't climb the lone flag. Keep your wands or watch. Be mindful of others.
Good morning, Springview Eagles. Today is Friday, November 22nd. I am Jacob Roberts.
And I'm Kaden Owen.
Stay in touch with what is going on at Springview via Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. Reminder, please turn off all cell phones now and put them away. Whitney High School JROTC on campus today. Whitney High's JROTC will be on campus hosting a recruiting event during both lunches today. All are welcome to stop by and learn about the program.
Thanksgiving break. Campus will be closed for Thanksgiving break Monday, November 25th to Friday, November 29th. School will resume Monday, December 2nd. Have a safe and relaxing break. Fall dance coming up. The fall dance will be held in the Multi on Friday, December 6th from 6 to 8 p.m. Tickets will go on sale this week of December 3rd.
Did you know that this day in history, in 1935, the Chinese Clipper took off from Alameda, California, carrying 100,000 pieces of mail in the first Trans-Pacific airmail flight.
So today I'm here with Miss Dean to talk to her about her biking trip to Colorado. First, how was your trip?
Trip was amazing. We rode about 2,000 miles from Coloma, California to Colorado. From Colorado, we visited a friend, and then we rode our bikes to Glenwood Springs, where we took the train to Reno, and then we rode our bikes home from Reno to Coloma. It was about 37 days, and it was 37 amazing days. We had about 7 days that were layover days, where we would just hang out and relax and see a beautiful town or visit some friends. But for 30 of those days, we were riding about 80 miles a day. We rode through the Nevada desert, 85 miles with nothing but beautiful scenery. Some people are intimidated by the desert, but when you're out there, it's pretty beautiful when you're just you and nature and you're just riding your bike and worrying about getting to your destination and what you're gonna eat for dinner.
What's your favorite part of the trip?
Yeah, that's really hard to like pick one favorite part because every day had something more amazing than the previous day. But I have to say, I'll remember that my 25th anniversary was actually on the road. Yeah, my husband and I celebrated riding through Rocky Mountain National Park, and I'll never forget it because the winds were blowing so hard that we had to walk our bikes downhill. Like, it was so bad, like we were afraid we were gonna get blown over. But we got to the top and we're in our Gore-Tex and we're at like over 12,000 feet elevation. And luckily there was a visitor center and we had hot chocolate and chili and just regrouped and thought about how glad we were that we didn't blow off the side of the road into the tundra. And after that we got to ride downhill and it was beautiful. Rocky Mountains were filled with craggy mountains and tundra fields and animals, and that's something I've always wanted to do, so I'm glad we got to do that. So that was pretty memorable.
Is there anything else you'd like to tell us about the trip?
Yeah, actually maybe more about bike touring in general. Bike touring is pretty amazing, and if you ever get to do it, you should. And what bike touring is basically you load up your bikes with your camping gear and you're living off the road for as many days as you want. But the beautiful thing about it is that you meet some interesting people, and you meet people who are really kind and generous, and they wouldn't normally talk to you if you were doing the same trip in a car. They wouldn't care, but since you're riding a bike, they want to know about you and what you're doing, and so I have to say that it's a really good way to see the country, maybe to see the world, and to meet people.
Good morning, Springview Eagles. Today's weather is going to be a high of 67 degrees, a low of 42 degrees. Winds are going to be like 5 miles per hour and humidity is at 55%. Next week, expect rain on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Saturday. Winds are going to be blowing in the upper 12 mile per hour for the first 3 days of rain, and it drops down to a 10 mile per hour radius on Saturday. And this is about as far as I can look. Have a great rest of your Thanksgiving break, Eagles.
The dance is coming up on Friday, December 6th. Tickets will be on sale the week of the dance. You can buy them at the student store during your lunch. Monday through Thursday, the tickets will be $3, and on Friday, they will be $5. The dance will be held on the most
Make sure to go,
hey guys! So we just found out our dance thing for this year, and drum roll please.